Hello.
Hi.
I'm Carly.
Hi. I'm Connor.
Welcome to Second Edition.
Thanks.
Yeah. It's gonna be a good class.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah. So what you missed, we're gonna learn how to cook a duck in this class.
Oh, okay.
And there's gonna be a bit of news.
Okay.
We may also watch a movie.
Maybe.
So, for now, just be ready for a new perspective on the world.
Okay.
Good evening. The construction of the new downtown arena, Rogers Place, is now underway.
However, Edmontonians are facing road blockages due to the project. The first phase for Rogers Place includes excavating soil for the underground parquet, which is expected to take several months to complete.
Already the north side of 104th Avenue has been closed to pedestrians. As the project advances, the northern lane of 104th Avenue will be closed down to allow some extra room for the work and the operation to go on there.
There's no set date for the lane closure just yet. However, three eastbound lanes and two westbound lanes will be repainted along the avenue to facilitate traffic during that construction period.
Almost 2 weeks after the Olympics, the idea of reformed liquor laws is still prevalent here in Edmonton. After a successful morning in bars all across Edmonton, talks have been sparked about possibly reforming Alberta's liquor laws. Yet while many acknowledge that no decision should be made based off of one event, Graham Last of the Canadian Brewhouse thinks it's worth examining.
Giving them the opportunity to stick around longer if they're able to, not everyone getting pushed out in the cold like it's minus 35 right now and being stuck trying to line up for cabs. You know, I can't see too many negatives in it, that's for sure.
The Alberta Liquor and Gaming Commission say they won't be making any changes anytime soon. Until then, many believe the idea is worth discussing, possibly over a pint.
The Edmonton Science Olympics is one of many events held during March for National Engineering and Geoscience Month. This program demonstrates how the principles of science affect our everyday lives.
Until your stuff has been cleaned up, stay with your towers.
This inter-school event ranges from grades 1 to 12, encouraging students to test the boundaries of science and create innovative problem-solving strategies.
There's medals and the other awards and certificates that are distributed.
The Association of Professional Engineers and Geoscientists of Alberta, APEGA, is the Edmonton Science Olympics' main sponsor and is proudly participating in their 21st year. The program recognizes students' accomplishments with rewards.
For the Alberta government, March is Fraud Prevention Month, reminding everyone that now might be a good time to change their password. February 27th was named Change Your Password Day, kicking off the 10th annual Fraud Prevention Month. A conference was held Tuesday to help educate about the issue.
Protect your information. When you get bills, just don't throw them in the garbage. Shred them. Shred your bank statements. Shred anything with any personal information on it that somebody could use.
Scott Hood claims fraud is becoming more common and growing all the time. Last year, over 45,000 cases were reported. Each week, Service Alberta and EPS will be focusing on a different type of fraud and what can be done to prevent it.
NAIT's Women in Technology and Trades Advisory Committee is a group dedicated to informing female students on the great opportunities that are provided in technical fields. With men being most common in trade schools, women are still underrepresented in a majority of trades. NAIT's committee values diversity within the programs and supports women through enrollment.
Positions are opening up, and for women, statistically speaking, they're safer. They handle equipment, they're easier on the equipment, and employers want them.
NAIT's Women in Technology and Trades Advisory Committee is hoping to spark more female interest by hosting a high-profile female guest speaker, Jill Drader, on March 13th.
NAIT proudly displays the phrase, essential to Alberta, on its pedway, and a new study release proves exactly that. NAIT is one of Canada's leading polytechnic institutes, sporting over 50,000 students with a 93% graduate employment rate. The school offers programs for all walks of life with everything from business administration to heavy-duty mechanics. NAIT's impact on Alberta's economy is greater than $1.5 billion, and NAIT President Dr. Glenn Feltham doesn't see this stopping anytime soon.
What does a student get from coming to NAIT, and what does the Alberta government get from investing a dollar in NAIT? And I think that's where NAIT truly shines. There's no better investment that a student can make than in an education at NAIT.
With Alberta's constant growth and development, it only seems fitting that NAIT grows with it. NAIT students who live far away might be happy to hear that they're developing plans for a NAIT residency.
With the increase of students, NAIT is diving further into their plans for accessible and cheap housing. And now to Lydia Ward for more information.
For many students at NAIT, life will be getting a little easier with the developing plans for new housing. President of NAIT said Jonathan Bilodeau says that NAIT has proven there is a demand for about 1,400 students and that NAIT will start with smaller housing.
We continue to work with the city and with the province on acquiring lands related to the airport lands or the Blanchford campus. We are very much hoping that our student housing will be on those lands.
There is no timeline for the project, but with the growing number of students near and far, NAIT is hoping to get dates set and contracts signed as soon as possible. This will be beneficial for students who live far away from NAIT and for students who find it difficult to make it to classes on time.
Grant McEwen will find that there are fewer students who will be taking up their residency in the next couple of years. NAIT's co-op with Grant McEwen has served students well in the past, but with new plans for housing for NAIT specifically designed for those students, students are awaiting in anticipation for the final decision.
NAIT Millwright student Zach shares his perspective on the housing situation specifically for trade students.
Because I'm in the trades program and I'm only here for 2 months and then I take off.
The City Center Airport, which is located on 109th Street, has been closed for almost a year and may be the new home for many NAIT students. You can visit nait.ca for more updates. This is Lydia Ward for Second Edition.
And now for a look at what's going on in sports, here's Aaron Bordato.
I heard we're going to be getting another banner.
Yes, that's right, Megan. We might actually need to invest in a whole other wall to house all the ones we've got. People from all over the country gathered in Edmonton this weekend for a special occasion. NAIT opened its arms and its doors when they hosted the 16th annual CCAA National Badminton Championships. Canada's top collegiate players gathered to compete for national supremacy as teams from all over the country gathered in the NAIT Arena. Teams from BC, Alberta, Ontario, and the Atlantic provinces brought forth their provincial winning teams in men's and women's singles, doubles, and mixed doubles. Six of the eight players selected to Team Alberta are from NAIT, with only two players from Concordia making the cut.
They're training all year round, and then this is their one big for school that they, you know, it's their one shot to win a national championship. So, you know, for them, the pressure's huge, and yeah, they're just doing their best and trying to win.
The weekend was a huge success, not only for the fans, but for NAIT as well, as they were able to take home a total of four medals, three of which were gold. The 7-0 Edmonton Rush looked to continue their perfect season last Friday when they took on the Toronto Rock. We pick things up at 1-1 now when Corey Conway delivers the beautiful behind-the-back feed to Curtis Knight, who then sets up Mark Matthews for the goal. 2-1 Rush. 3-3 now as Casey Behrens finishes off the gorgeous passing play from Stephen LeBlanc. 4-3 Rock as we head into the second quarter. 5-4 now as on the power play, Corey Conway fakes one way and delivers another behind-the-back pass to Robert Church for his seventh of the year. We take you now to the third quarter as Riley Lowen comes streaking in the house and rips a shot just wide of the net. But no worries as Jared Davis is there to clean up the rebound and make it a tie game. Play of the game now as Jeremy Don't Call Me Rattail Thompson decides to take it in alone and rips the game winner top shelf. The Rush improved their record to a perfect 8-0 on the year and will look to continue that next week against Vancouver. The Edmonton Oil Kings looked to bounce back after a tough loss to the Calgary Hitmen when they took on the Saskatoon Blades on Sunday. After the Blades took a tripping minor 23 seconds into the game, it was Cody Corbett receiving the feed and ripping a clap bomb top cheddar to give his team the 1-0 lead. This was Corbett's 16th of the year, which now gives him the lead for franchise third defenseman. Fast forward 3 minutes, and after some gritty forechecking, it's Mitch Morrows laying the body and receiving the feed down low to put away his 33rd of the year. Only 4 minutes in, and it's already 2-0 Oil Kings. Blades goalie Troy Trombley was tested again right away as the Oil Kings came in on a 2-on-1, but was able to make the clutch 5-hole save. We come now to the second period as backup goalie Tyler Santos faces his first test of the night and stops Chase Clayton on a solo breakaway. Still 2-0 Oil Kings. Shortly after, it was Trombley's turn as Mitch Moreau comes streaking in on a breakaway, which loses control of the puck after being hooked. Time for everybody's play, a penalty shot. Moraz takes the scenic route to the net, but can't get a shot off as he loses control of the puck on his way. Still 2-0. The Oil Kings didn't have to wait long, however, as Riley Keyser comes streaking down the right side of the ice and Roops one top corner for his 13th of the year. 3-0 Oil Kings. We take you now to the 2-minute mark of the third period as things got a little crazy when not one, but two scraps broke out simultaneously on the ice. Blake Orban took exception to a late slash behind the play from Austin Adamson and finished him off with an impressive uppercut top of the head combo that sent him to the ice for good. The Blades' late game rally was unsuccessful as the Oil Kings came out on top 3-0. Backup goalie Tyler Santos earned his third shutout of the year, while head coach Derek Laxdale was unimpressed with the Blades' lack of respect, but was pleased with his team efforts after the game.
Yeah, a little bit more respect for the other team than what was going on tonight. But the other day was a good 2 points for us. Good bounce back game from last night. That we played a solid game there. That, you know, Trombley was probably the difference. Could have been 6 or 7, but good 2 points for us tonight.
Those look to be quite the physical games out there, Aaron.
They sure were, Quinton.
That's been your look at news and sports. Here's Connor and Carly.
Yoga's so relaxing.
I'm so relaxed right now.
Did you know this pose is actually very good for digestion?
Really? Because I feel like I'm going to throw up.
So much to learn.
Yeah. There is a lot to learn about yoga.
Did you know that hatha yoga is the most commonly known form of yoga? But there are many different kinds, such as raja yoga, karmic yoga, and others. Did you know? The early history of yoga is unknown, but is thought to have existed since 500 BCE. Did you know that many celebrities practice yoga, including Robert Downey Jr., Sting, Charlie Sheen, Madonna, Jeff Bridges, and Nicolas Cage? Did you know that the Edmonton Yoga Studio is the only yoga studio endorsed by yours truly, located on 12039 127th Street in Edmonton, offering classes, workshops, retreats?
So much to learn about yoga. This pose is all about relaxing and letting go of inner tension.
We're gonna go to a commercial.
Choice. You can choose excitement or relaxation. Work.
All right.
Or play. Your choice can result in mistakes and successes. But the choice is always yours. Big Rock. Choose your own adventure.
What if you had the power to listen to what you want, when you want it?
Take charge with NR92.
Call our request line.
Your station, your way.
Hey there, lady. What are you doing? Oh, you're making a drink. Having a little trouble with that ice? Here, let me take that ice. Really, it's no problem. I'm gonna grab my traditional and give it a little bang, bang, bang. That's right, I'm breaking the ice with a big rock. There, done. You're welcome. Oh my, you're still gonna make that girly drink, eh? Oops. Here, have a big rock instead. Touch it. Here's to you, little lady. Be traditional. Break the ice with a big rock. Or you can wait for it to melt.
Mm-hmm.
take a break for the new Music Nooner.
Tune in to NR92 and get connected.
New Music Nooner, exposing local music in your city.
Hi, welcome to Cooking with Daniel. I'm Carly Robinson, joined by Daniel Rosaliro. And so today we're going to be cooking something different for the people who are tired of the traditional meats. So tell us a bit about this.
Yes, we're going to do duck breast. I'm going to show you how to properly sear and treat your duck breast. So back here we have a little membrane that you want to take out just for chewiness.
Oh, okay.
And then on the front side we're going to give it a quick score, which we want to just lightly get the skin.
Okay.
It's nice and
is
light.
Is this to get the oils out? Because I've heard duck is a very oily.
It's supposed to get all the fat from the skin where the duck hides all its delicious goodness. So we're just going to do it nice and light, not to score the actual meat.
Okay.
We're going to put it in a nice hot pan.
Yeah.
And then have it searing for about 5 minutes. Flip it over and pop it in the oven for about 20 minutes.
Okay.
And you would actually get a nice product where it's perfectly seared on both sides, which will look like this.
Okay, so this is the one's a bit more rare.
This one is a little more rare. This is how I personally would eat my duck. It was both mid-rare, mid-well. Mm-hmm. Most people like a little more well done, which is like up front.
Okay, how did you cook these vegetables?
I cooked them actually in the duck fat that we rendered off the breast.
Okay.
And we just mixed it in with a little salt, a little pepper, and then just threw them in the oven, let them roast till they're perfectly cooked, or however you like them cooked, basically.
Okay, do you have any other tips or tricks for people when they're cooking with duck?
Just make sure you render the fat as much as possible. If you turn down the oven temperature just a little bit, it'll actually render the skin nicely, and you want it nice and crisp, just so that it's not chewy and fatty and
okay. So rendering is to bring
is the key.
Down.
Yeah, rendering it takes all the fat out and gets it all nice and crispy.
I was wondering, could you tell us a little bit more about the greens that you have on top
here?
Oh
yes, we have our microgreens from our in-house cultivator that we grow ourselves. Some of the students actually just plant them, and these are actually kale.
Kale, okay, that's interesting. And so this is a nice dish to cook at home for sort of your springtime or whenever really.
Exactly.
So this has been Cooking with Ernest, and today we learned how to sear a duck. And thank you, Daniel, for joining us.
I just love this. What are you looking at?
A viral video.
Ah, what's it gonna be this week?
I'm guessing it's gonna have something to do with yoga.
For this week's viral video, we take a look at someone with some epic dance moves, and even better, yoga poses.
Labyrinth, come in.
Little Crab combines yoga and breakdancing into something extraordinary.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is
wow.
Groundbreaker. So let me first apologize.
I can do that.
The shirt and the ties for your makeup. Cause I make you ugly.
That's awesome.
We're on a rampage. Bubbles popping up before you know it.
Well, I hope you found this week's viral video inspiring, because I sure did. Namaste.
So the whole point of this mindfulness exercise is to clear your mind of all thoughts.
I'd rather be watching a movie right now.
For this week's movie review, we're here to talk about The Love Guru.
Yes, it's funny and wacky, and also, it's Canadian.
Let's take a look.
I had a hat like that once.
Yeah?
Then my mom got a job.
This movie stars some of Hollywood's well-known actors, such as Mike Myers, Jessica Alba, and the man that brought sexy back, Justin Timberlake, as well as many more.
Even with a cast of well-known actors, the writing and the acting in this film was horrific.
The film takes place where a love guru from India, who has great yoga skills,
travels to Canada to help an NHL All-Star who plays for the Toronto Maple Leafs get back with his wife, who is seeing an All-Star goaltender who plays for the LA Kings. This is all happening in the Stanley Cup Finals.
Even though the movie had cameo appearances from Rob Blake and Oprah Winfrey, it still doesn't give what the audience wanted.
The Golden Raspberries gave them 7 nominations. Out of the 7, it won 3, including Worst Actor for Mike Myers and Worst Picture.
This angry Leaf fan explains it better when he is yelling at Jessica Alba.
Ooh, you suck, mother!
No, you suck!
I don't think I could have said it better myself.
Well, as you can see, that is not one of Mike Myers' better movies.
Even though the Stanley Cup does come back to Canada, I have to give this movie 1 Warrior's Pose.
And I personally give it 1 Downward Dog out of 5. Join us next week.
Hopefully it's a better film.
Oh, I'm so excited for this massage. Best way to end second edition.
The best part of it too, the ending.
Yeah, what did you learn?
The Love Guru is a terrible movie.
Well, I learned how to sear a duck.
And we watched a viral video.
Yeah, and there was the news in there too.